Welcome back to Star Trek Nitpickers.
Star Trek Short Trek's first episode, Runaway, is an ambitious introduction to a new kind of Star Trek story. Never before has an official Star Trek story been told on screen in such a short amount of time. If you cut off the trim, it's about 13 and a half minutes, so as you'd expect, it's fast-paced. You find the plot moving along through quick lines of dialogue that may not seem as important as they are because you think the show has time for small talk. Then you realize it doesn't.
Not one for small talk, are you?
I don't have time for that.
The sci-fi space graphics are great, but it's really a character-driven piece with Tilly and the guest star taking up most of the screen time. The episode's wonderfully scored by Jeff Russo, who seems to understand how to bring out the heart of the scene with the score. The music helps you follow what's going on, as a good score tends to do. Runaway is unpredictable in a fun way, if not entirely surprising. Surprises can be good or bad, and while there are some of both in this episode, you won't be able to figure out the middle or end after seeing the beginning. As far as the science fiction aspect of Runaway goes, the plot does center around a revolutionary new piece of technology, a cornerstone of quality science fiction. Now the other side of the coin. One of the challenges of telling a short story is jamming enough information into it to make it worthwhile, to make it original and unique, but to also keep it short and fast-paced. Runaway goes through so many changes in the first 7 minutes that it's easy to get a little lost. The guest character, Poe, is depicted as one thing after another, and it adds a sense of confusion as to what's going on. While there aren't a lot of plot twists, there are a lot of character twists, and it makes it hard to understand and believe Poe's character. Another thing you often find in a short story is a character changing. We see that here, but it feels unrealistic that such a serious change could happen in such a short amount of time. There's an overall disconnected from reality feeling that's reinforced by the absence of the other Discovery characters. Star Trek's always been a team effort, an ensemble cast, up till now. Tilly's reasons for keeping the rest of the crew out of the situation are ultimately unsatisfying. There are kind of a few plot holes. One large one that really confused me: Tilly doesn't seem to have any sense of danger. It's hard to believe someone in her situation would react the way she does, and that makes the whole world of the story come apart at the seams just a bit. The fact that we don't know where the ship is, or who's in command, or what mission they're currently on, also adds to the sense of confusion when key plot points come up. While there is a lot to like about this episode, we get to see a couple of new sides of Tilly's character. She's exuberantly well acted by Mary Wiseman. The story involves the politics of new technology. Well, ultimately the ending doesn't really work though, because the climax is so easy to miss. Part of the problem is the conflict is hard to identify. The threat just isn't clear. This is a very different kind of a Star Trek story, and perhaps as time goes on, we'll become more accustomed to this format, and they'll get better at writing it. Like the original Star Trek format, morality comes into play. Unlike the original format, the moral feels cut and dry at the end. Everything's wrapped up nicely, instead of leaving you thinking and questioning. Let me know what you think. Thanks a lot, and please remember to subscribe. Live long and prosper.